Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? Me here to teach the chemistry. Before starting the lecture, there are some instructions you must keep in your mind. Number one, don't raise your hand during lecture. Ask questions at the end. And keep your chemistry book with you. Then today we are going to start Chapter 1, Introduction of a Chemistry, and you have to open the page number 1. Before going to the definition of a chemistry, we must know about the basic thing, that what is the science. Science is a study of things and events that take place around us. Means the things and events that take place around us in our surrounding is known as a science. Basically, science is divided into three main branches: biology, chemistry, and physics. Now, we will consider chemistry here because we are here for the chemistry class. Now, first, we must know about the definition of the chemistry. Chemistry is a branch of a science that deals with the properties, composition, and structure of a matter. Chemistry also deals with the changes involved in the matter. It also deals with the principle governing the changes in the matter may undergo. Means chemistry is a total related with the matter. Matter, we must know the matter. This is a basic thing you all must know. But matter is a thing which matter. Is a thing which having anything which having the weight and occupy a space is called the matter. So matter is a basic thing for the chemistry. So we can summarize the definition of a chemistry. We can say the branch of a science which deals with composition, structure, properties, and reaction of a matter. Mean what is the composition of a specific matter? Mean you can take any element, what is its composition, what is the properties, and what about the structure. These and what changes occur when the reaction take place, these all things are related to the chemistry or come under to the chemistry branch. So I'm repeating, the branch of the science which deals with the composition, structure, properties, and a reaction of a matter. Then chemistry is divided into various branches, but we will discuss only main and important branches of chemistry. So first branch we having the physical chemistry. It is a branch of chemistry which deals with the laws and principles governing the combination of atoms and the molecule in a chemical reaction. So in physical chemistry we are discussing about how reaction take place, means which under which law and which principle they are following for that specific chemical reaction. In other words, we can say in this branch we deal with the relationship between the composition and the physical properties of a matter along with the change of them. So it's totally related to laws and principles which are governing to a specific chemical reaction or a reaction. The properties of such as a structure of atom or the formation of the molecules, behavior of our gases, liquids, and gas and solids, and the study of the effect of the temperature or radiation of a matter are studied under this branch. So physical chemistry is totally related to the laws and principles. Then next branch is we having the organic chemistry. This is one of the important branch of chemistry, that is organic chemistry. It can be defined as a branch of chemistry that deals with the carbon compounds and exception of carbon dioxide, carbon, metal carbonates, bicarbonates, and carbides. Actually, it is a chemistry of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. most of the consumer products are organic in nature. Mean organic chemistry is related to the study of our carbons and the hydrogen. Those compounds which having carbon and hydrogen, they are known as a hydrocarbon. So it is totally related to the study of our carbon and hydrogen. But exception of our carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide, carbonates, bicarbonates and carbon. Exception of these, all the carbon compounds are studied under the organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is one of the important branch for the industry. Organic chemistry, we study this compound are known as the organic compound. Organic chemistry determines the structure and the properties of these naturally occurring as well as synthesized compounds. Scope of this branch covers petroleum, petrochemical and pharmaceutical industry. Means on industrial level, organic chemistry is a very important for a petroleum and pharmaceutical. Pharmaceutical mean where medicines are known as a pharmaceutical industry. So these are very important branch. Now next, inorganic chemistry. Third branch in organic chemistry, it is a branch of a chemistry that deals with the chemistry of elements and their compounds generally obtained from a non-living organism, that is from a minerals. Means those compounds which are obtained from the non-living organisms are considered under the inorganic compounds. In other words, we can see the study of all elements and their compound, except those of compound of carbon and hydrogen, that is a hydrocarbon, and their derivatives. It has application to every aspect of a chemical industry, such as a glass, cement, ceramics, and metallurgy. Metallurgy is a new term for you. It means extraction of a metal from its ore, mean raw material of a ore from which we get the main metal, that is known as a metallurgy. So inorganic chemistry is also one of the important branch in which we obtain many important industrial products. I have discussed you with glass, cement, ceramics, these and extraction of a metal. All these are come in the under the heading of inorganic chemistry. Then we having the next branch, analytical chemistry. It's a branch of a chemistry that deals with the study of a methods and the techniques involved to determine the kind, quality and quantity of a various component in a given substance. It means in this branch we will discuss about the method and techniques, how we will do the different processes. For this we can define or in another way the branch of chemistry that deal with the separation and analysis of a sample to identify its components. Suppose we are identifying the different components or a different elements by the help of analytical chemistry, we can separate out, we can analyze and we can differentiate between two elements. The separation is carried out into a quantitative and qualitative analysis, and qualitative analysis provides us the identity of the substance, mean composition of a chemical species. On other hand, quantitative analysis determines the amount of the each component present in the sample. So this branch is very important as technique and instrument used for the analysis to for the studies. And this branch has scope for it covers the food, water, environmental, and a clinical analysis. This branch is totally related to the food industry. It's related to our water for different processes, environmental pollution, and environment also, how the different elements cause a harm in the environment. So these are all related to the analytical chemistry. So It is again one of the important branch by which we can find out the different methods and techniques to analyze the different elements. Now, next we having the biochemistry. Biochemistry. The word biochemistry shows it link with the bio, mean biology. So it can be defined as it deal with the compounds of a living organism, that is plants and animals, and their metabolism in the living body. So it is a relationship between bio and chemistry. In other words, we can say it's a study the structure, composition, and the chemical reaction of substances found in living organism. Mean all the chemical reaction which occur in your body which relate to the biochemistry. It covers all chemical processes take place in living organism, such as synthesizes and metabolism of biomolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. It is its application of a biochemistry are in the field of a medicines, food sciences, and agriculture. So biochemistry is a totally related to the compounds of a living organism, either animals, either humans, either the plant. We will discuss all the compounds of a living organism, which type of reactions take place in your body, in animals, on the plant, or really comes under the heading of a biochemistry. So it is a one of the most important branch. It is a backbone of the chemistry. Without this chemistry, a branch of this chemistry, we cannot move forward in progress of the country. Then we having industrial chemistry. Another important branch, that is industrial chemistry, its name showing it's related to an industry. A deal with the study of different chemical processes involved in the chemical industries for the manufacture of the synthesis product, synthetic products like glass, cement, paper, soda ash, fertilizer, medicine, all these are come under the industrial chemistry. In other words, we can see it deal with the manufacturing of a chemical compounds on a commercial scale. It's called industrial chemistry. It deals with the manufacturing of a basic chemicals. I have already told the names, but I am once again repeating: oxygen, chlorine, ammonia. These are caustic soda, nitric acid, sulfuric acid. These chemicals provide the raw material for many other industries such as fertilizers, soap, textiles, agriculture, food products, paints, and paper, etc. So industrial chemistry is one of the important branch. We will all type of the food, either food, packed food, soaps, fertilizers, agriculture products, and all type of sodas which are using in a different industries are manufactured in a in industry for the development of a different processes. Important gases like oxygen, chlorine, ammonia, and important liquids like acids like nitric acid, sulfuric acid, all these are come in the industrial chemistry. And soda industry, in which different type of sodas, caustic soda, baking soda, washing soda, the soda industry is also, but this come under this branch, that is the industrial chemistry. So once again, it's one of the most important branch of the chemistry for the development of a country. Then nuclear chemistry. Next branch is the nuclear chemistry. Its name showing that it's related to a nucleus. Nuclear chemistry means related to something nucleus. Now, definition of the branch is a branch of a chemistry that deals with the study of changes occurring in the nuclei of atoms accompanied by the emission of an invisible radiation. Means this branch related to the what type of a change is occurring in the nucleus of the atom. So in other words, this is a branch of a chemistry that deals with the radioactivity. Radioactivity, nuclear process and properties. By the help of a radioactivity process, we will split a nucleus and study these properties. The main concerns of this branch is with the atomic energy and its uses in a daily life. It is also include the study of chemicals effect resulting from the absorption of a radiation with animals, plants and other materials. It has a vast application in a medical treatment, radiotherapy, prevention of foods and generation of electric power through a nuclear reactor, etc. So this branch is important for the generation of the electric power station and is used for the prevention of a food and for in terms other medical treatment, it is used in a radiotherapy, which is an important one for the treatment of a cancer. So nuclear chemistry is a most important branch for the medical treatment today. We know that this era, where many people are suffering from the cancer, the treatment of a cancer with the help of a radiotherapy, and this is totally based on radioactivity of a nucleus and nuclei of the atom. So it's, and also it's this branch team what effects of the these radiation on animal, plants and other animals. These all things are considered under this branch. Now next we having environmental chemistry. Its name showing that environmental chemistry related to the environment. It's a branch of a chemistry that deals with the study of interaction of chemical materials and their effects on the environment of animals and the plants. Personal hygiene, pollution and health hazards are most important areas of environmental chemistry. Means in this branch we discuss about the interaction of a chemical material and what side effects showing after the interaction of a chemical material on environment. In other words, we can say it's branch of chemistry in which we study about the component of the environment and the effects of our human activities on the environment. Environmental chemistry is related to the other branches like biology, geology, ecology, soil and water. The knowledge of a chemical processes take place in the environment is necessary for the improvement and the protection against pollution. Mean what type of interaction of a chemical materials occur? It must have a side effect. This side effect, how it affects our environment, animals, humans. To save from these effects, we will study the environmental chemistry, how to save the living organism from the effects of the chemicals in the maybe in the form of a gases, maybe in the solids, maybe a gas. They affect our environment. So to minimize the pollution, and we can how to do the personal hygiene, how to reduce the health hazard. These are all are come under the environmental chemistry. Again, once again, important branch for all the living things. Now next we having the polymeric chemistry. It's a branch of a chemistry. It deals especially with the study of a polymerization and the products obtained through the process of a polymerization, such as a plastic, synthetic fiber and paper, etc. You all know or aware about the plastic. Polymerization is a process by which we obtain the product like a plastic. Synthetic fibers, synthetic means a man-made fibers and a paper. These are under terms in the polymeric chemistry. polymeric chemistry is an important branch of a chemistry in which we are getting plastic, synthetic paper. So these are one of the major need or the demand of the society. We all the time in any industry, in home, school, everywhere we are using the plastic. Either plastic, you can take the example like we are using the plastic in the making of bottles, school bottles. Your home furniture made of maybe something made of plastic. In kitchens, we are using the plastic. In pipes, you are using in houses. These are all made up of plastics. And paper is one of the most important and in need of the society. Without paper, we cannot do anything. So we imagine without paper, we cannot do anything. It means our school system totally depend upon the paper. Fibers are the used in the in different industry for making the different types of cloths, fabrics. You know, so in a way, polymeric chemistry is an important chemistry branch. It's related with the polymerization main process, related to the making of the plastic, synthetic fibers and paper. So this is the ninth and last branch of chemistry, but is one of the important branch for us. It is very helpful in the industry. So I have discussed with you nine branches of a chemistry. One is a physical, organic, inorganic chemistry, analytical chemistry, biochemistry, industrial chemistry, nuclear chemistry, environmental chemistry, and the polymeric. These are all are the major branches of a chemistry. We have so many branches of a chemistry, but we have, in our syllabus, where only important branches are discussed in detail. So every branch of a chemistry has its own importance in a human life. We all know that without chemistry, we can do nothing. One of the important branches is biochemistry. It's a backbone of our medical sciences. Medical sciences totally depend upon the biochemistry. I have already told you that bio and chemistry is a relationship between bio and chemistry. So environmental chemistry tells us about the environment, composition, and how one can protect its environment from the environmental hazards. Today environment is totally polluted, and how we can save our environment or we can protect our environment from environmental hazards. So we are studying under this branch. So what type of a chemical we are using in industry, what are the hazards, we all discuss in this branch, and how to overcome this problem is considered under the environmental chemistry. Industrial chemistry helps us in the manufacturing of our industry products and their uses. Industry, you have already know industrial chemistry. We have discussed different type. All the things are made in the industry. So like glass, cements, sodas, these are all are made in the industrial chemistry. So it's important one. Analytical chemistry is important to understand the composition of a compound, quality of a product, analysis of biological samples such as water, milk, urine, blood, soil, and the use of research techniques such as chromatography and spectroscopy. These are the two processes, chromatography and spectroscopy, by which we can analyze our type of a water, with type of a component, either maybe it's a polluted or not, and a milk, what is the composition of a milk, what are the things that are added into our milk which are not fit for our health, urine, in the test of a urine, what is the composition of a urine, and what type of unimportant things are present in your urine, blood, soil, and these are all are tested by and under the process of a chromatography and spectroscopy. So this is again once important. Nuclear chemistry provides us radioisotopes for the treatment of many diseases such as cancer, and also give the atomic energy for the benefits of man. You all know atomic energy is used for the different purposes. So it is very important, and it has a great benefit for the mankind and then for the safety of the country. So I have summarized the importance of our branches of our chemistry. I hope you must, all of you have understand. Now, after the discussing about the branches of a chemistry, next come importance of a chemistry. What is the relationship of a chemistry and the society? First, we must know about the significance reasons. Significant reason to study the chemistry. First thing is a significance. Significant mean important reasons why we are studying the chemistry. So here there are three significant reasons we are studying chemistry. Once again I am repeating, significant mean important. The first significant reason why we are studying is that chemistry has an important practical application in the society. The development of our life-saving drug, the one and the complete list, would touch upon the most areas of our modern technology. Mean chemistry can directly apply in our society. For example, we are in the life-saving drugs. If we are suffering from any disease, so that the disease can be cured by our drugs, medicine, that is a benefit of the chemistry. By the help of the chemistry, we can save lives, or we can save from the any type of a disease. So this is a one of the significant reason why we are studying this, studying the chemistry. Second reason why we are studying the chemistry is a it's an intellectual enterprise, a way of explaining our material world. Intellectual enterprise means ability to think new projects, new things. So chemistry is an intellectual enterprise, means chemistry enhanced to think about new projects, new things. So this is a way to explaining our the material world. And third reason, chemistry figures prominently in the other fields, such as in biology, in the advancement of medicines. Mean I have already told you there is a relation, important relationship between biology and chemistry. They work side by side. So chemistry has an important role other branches, but especially in the biology. So these are the three significant reasons we are studying the chemistry. Once again I am repeating, first it has a practical application in the society. Second one is it's a intellectual enterprises, it's mean it's enhanced our ability to think and do a new projects. And finally, last one is it figures prominently in other fields like a biology. Mean biology and chemistry having a relationship. Without chemistry, bio cannot work. Medicines are come under the bio, that's a totally related to chemistry. So these are the significant reasons for studying the chemistry. Now, after studying the significant reason, mean important reason why we are studying chemistry. Now, what is the importance of a chemistry in our society? Next thing is, chemistry has played important role for well-being of the mankind in the form of food, clothing, shelter, medical treatment, chemical fertilizers, crops protected by insecticide, refined food, and production of artificial fiber. So chemistry play a very, very important role for human being or the mankind. I will discuss about the food, cloths, shelters, medical treatment, chemical fertilizers, refined food, or an artificial fiber. These are all are the blessing of the chemistry. The production of a cement, iron, bricks, paint, etc. is all due to the chemistry. We all know that if we are constructing a house, so we need a cement, iron, bricks, paint. All these things are because of a chemistry. Without this, we cannot construct a house. So this is again one of the important blessing or use of the or impact the society. the benefits of a chemistry are so vast that no aspect of a human life has remained unaffected. So chemistry is a very important for the man. There are different chemicals which are very important in our daily life. We will discuss here. One of them is the chlorine. Chlorine is one of the major element which is used in the chemical industry, either in the form of a gas, either in the form of a liquid is used. So one of the uses, it is using in a baking polyvinyl chloride compound that uses bleaching agent, and it uses a pesticide, refrigerants, flame retardant, and drugs. It is used in a treating water to kill the pathogenic disease-causing organisms. In this way, most of the diseases like cholera, typhoid, fever, and dysentery are the dangerous diseases are eliminated from the most of the part of the world. This is all about the related to chlorine. And beside the chlorine, we are having the fluorine, which is also important, which is used in our toothpaste from prevention from the tooth decay, and it's having the important compounds like tin fluoride, SNF2, and sodium fluorophosphate, Na2PO4F, and NaF sodium fluoride. All these are used in a toothpaste to protect and control tooth decay. This is about today's lesson. Now we will wind up here, and before winding, we having the home task. We have to share the home task. Please take a picture of your home task or a screenshot, and please do this question in your fair copy. The first question is, list out the three significant reasons to study a chemistry. First, you have to write the question with a black pointer, and your main heading is the significant reason with a black cut marker. Then you will write the three significant points, 1, 2, 3, and like this. Then second question is, define chemistry and explain different branches of a chemistry. First, you will put the heading of a chemistry. You will write down the proper definition of a chemistry from your book, page number 1, and then different branches of a chemistry. Next, your main heading is branches of a chemistry. Then you will write the following are the main branches of chemistry. Then you will write down the name of one branch of chemistry, then define them. Then next, one by one, you will do this. And you do your work in a fair copy. Okay, this is all about your home task, and this is all about our today's lesson. Okay, Allah Hafiz.